Okay, one more minute, then I'll start fast.
Yes, sir.
And I want complete silence this row, third bench onwards. And I'm solving no discussions and talkings in between. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Be attentive now. L, B, and W are the partners of a partnership firm, sharing profit and loss in the ratio of 2:2:1. Old ratio 2:5, 2:5, 1:5. Balance sheet of the firm on 31/3/16 was as under. Now, very first of all, from the balance sheet, Rushabh, what all will we write? And yes, capital and cash. Put take on capital and put take on cash. First of all, capitals. Silence. By balance brought down. Capitals are 20,000, 12,500 and 5,000. 20,000, 12,500 and 5,000. And put take on cash. Two balance brought down 2,000. Stop talking, I said. Now, Vrinda, what else from the balance sheet? Where will we write? Which side? What ratio? Yes, old ratio. Sit down, everyone, be a reader. General reserve 5,000 will come in partners, capital credit side. 2:2:1 ratio. 5,000 into 2:5, 2,000. 5,000 into 2:5, 2,000. 5,000 into 1:5, 1,000. The journal entry would have been general reserve account debit account gets closed. Two partners' capital, so partners' capital on debit side in old ratio. Is everyone clear with this?
Yes.
Pooja, what else from the balance sheet?
Goodwill.
All of you put take on goodwill. When will we write?
Partners' capital account debit.
Partners' capital account debit side to goodwill account. 8,000 into 2:5, 3,200. 8,000 into 2:5, 3,200. And 8,000 into 1:5, 1,600. Is everyone clear with this? The journal entry would have been partners' capital account, L's capital account debit, B's capital account debit, W's capital account debit. So partners' capital account on debit side. Two goodwill account, the goodwill account gets closed. Is everyone clear with this?
Yes, sir.
Nothing else from the balance sheet. Now, W retired on 1/4/2016. Which partner?
Third
partner retired. Terms of retirement were decided as under. Market value of building is 50,000. Ritu, tell me the effects. What will you do on the asset side? Keep standing. Jinal, tell it 100 times. After how many questions you understand revaluation's effects? Ritu, what is the value of building in balance sheet? Now what is its value? Is it profit or loss? 37,000 is building, now 50,000. Is it profit or loss? So profit will come in devaluation credit side. Is the value of building increasing or decreasing? Increasing, so plus in building. Write these two effects 100 times. First of all, devaluation account credit side by building account with the profit of 13,000 and put tick on building. Building 37,000 plus appreciation of 13,000, so outer column 50,000. Is everyone clear with this? Any doubts in that? Next. This we have done yesterday also. I'm reading it. Try the workings on your own. Book value of stock is 10% more than its cost. And now stock is to be recorded at its cost. Do the workings on your own and find the amount we have to increase. Question 10, we did third adjustment and I made the market important also. Without speaking, do it on your own. Let everyone try. Who all are able to get there, we have to decrease it by 500. Very good. Those who are not able to get, copy it. For stock, listen everyone, book value is 10% more than the cost. So suppose the cost price is 100 plus book value is 10% more, means it's 110. Now when book value is 110, cost is 100. Book value means value in the balance sheet. You can see in the balance sheet the value is 5,500. So if book value is 5,500, what is its cost? 5,500 into 100 upon 110, 5,000. Now it is given in the question that now we have to record it at cost. Means from 5,500 we have to decrease it by 500. Then we'll be able to bring it to 5,000 cost. Did everyone understand this? Who all could get this right? Very good. Now, method, effects. Yes, we have to decrease the stock. So revaluation account debit side to stock 500 and minus from stock. Put it on stock on asset side. 5,500 minus decrease of 500. So outer column 5,000. In bracket you can mention working note 1. Any confusion in this? All are clear with this? Now new adjustment, raise your hand and mark it important. Personal expense of W, rupees 500 was debited to profit and loss account. Personal expense of W was debited to profit and loss account. Salome. Very good, correct. Be attentive. Personal expense. So this is adjustment 3. Personal expense means, can I say correct entry is drawings to cash? Be attentive everyone. Now it is given that we have wrongly debited that to profit and loss account. Means instead of treating it as drawings, we have done profit and loss account debit to cash. Pass the correct entry, reverse the wrong. If you reverse the wrong, you will get cash to profit and loss account. So cash account will get cancelled. Okay, the rectification entry is drawings to profit and loss. Drawings, we will show in partner's capital account debit side. And 2 P&L means we will show it in revaluation account on credit side. Is everyone off the clear with this? Anyone having any doubt in this? So entry will be partner's capital to revaluation. Partner's capital account debit side to revaluation account in bracket personal expenses. It is W's personal expense. Yes. So in W's column 500. Understood that? And two revaluation, so revaluation credit side by W's capital account in bracket personal expense wrongly recorded 500. Mark it important and raise your hand who is not clear with this. All of you are clear with the rectification, Dania? Next. Goodwill of the firm is valued at 80,000. Now, in this chapter, for goodwill, Yashvi, what is the entry? Adjustments goodwill. Let the entry 100 times. Is that 3? 100 times. Dia? 100 times. Lovely? 2? 100 times. Tarun? 100 times. Yuvraj? Who's speaking in between? Correct, sit down. All this, stand up those who could not answer. Half of the chapter is how you people are doing the homework. Every question goodwill is there. Every question has goodwill. What are you people doing in the homework? Tarun, Riya, Vidyatri, and Yashvi. Write this entry 100 times by tomorrow. So many questions we have done by now. Remaining partners capital account debit to retiring partners capital account. But in which ratio?
Gain
ratio. So first we will find the gain ratio. Yes, stop talking. Look at the next adjustment. All of you look at the next adjustment. L will gain 5 by 40 and P will gain 3 by 40 and then from W's share of profit. From means which situation? Situation to gain share is directly given. Directly we have to do old ratio plus gain share will get the new ratio. Okay, we'll find the new ratio because it will be required in the last adjustment. And gain ratio we can directly get from this. Gain share is 5 by 40 and 3 by 40. So what is the gain ratio? 5 is to 3, 5 by 8 and 3 by 8. Is everyone clear with this? Directly from gain share we can get the gain ratio. So, add up L, B, W. Old ratio, 2 is to 1. 2 by 5, 2 by 5, 1 by 5. W retires. Gain share, which we understand from the word from, is 5 by 40 and
3 by 40.
In fact, yesterday we did complicated one. Gain ratio was given. So first we found gain share, retiring partner's share into gain ratio. And that I give you in homework also many objective examples. A new ratio, old ratio plus gain share. So 2 by 5 plus 5 by 40 and 2 by 5 plus 3 by 40. 40 is LCM. 40 divided by 5, 8 into 2, 16. 40 divided by 41 into 5, 5. And here again 40 divided by 5, 8 into 2, 16. 40 divided by 41 into 3, 3. 21 by 40, 19 by 40. This is the new ratio. And from gain share, we directly get the gain ratio. 5 by 40 and 3 by 40 means gain ratio is 5 is to 3. New ratio 21 is to 19. Gain ratio 5 is to 3. All these points in the beginning itself we have done in the summary. Okay, whatever situations are possible. Now for goodwill. Who is retiring? So, remaining partners debit means L's capital account debit and B's capital account debit. L's capital account debit. B's capital account debit. Two retiring means two. W's capital account. Are you all clear with this? Swara, which amount will be obtained first? How will we get? Tell me W's amount. Desha. Yes, first of all, goodwill's value is 80,000. Can you all see W's share is 1 by 5? So W's amount will be 80,000. Into 1 by 5, that is 16,000. Then tell me LMB's amount. That is? Gain ratio 5 by 8, 3 by 8. 16,000 into 5 by 8 and 16,000 into 3 by 8. 10,000 and 6,000. And mention here we have done it in gain ratio. Silence everyone. Yes, Pooja. Is everyone clear with this?
Yes.
W's amount 16,000 will distribute in the ratio of gain ratio that is 5 to 3. So 16,000 into 5 by 8, 16,000 into 3 by 8. Any doubts with that?
No.
No. One check. How will we write in partner's capital account debit side? Last bench, if I find any prompting in between, the whole last two benches will write this adjustment 100 times. What will we write debit side?
To L capital account, L capital account.
2L's capital account. You write 100 times that debit side will write credit accounts. Debit. And credit side will write debit accounts. Debit side will write? Tell me which is a credit account. So what will write on debit side? 2 W's capital account in bracket goodwill. Which amount in what column? L column 10,000. B column 6,000. Debit side will write credit account. So 2 W's capital account, L's column 10,000, B's column 6,000. Now credit side will write? Yes, credit side will write debit account. So by L's capital account and also by B's capital account in bracket goodwill, which column, what amount? Yes, sit down. W's column 10,000 and 6,000. Did you all understand the recording of this? Anyone having any doubt in it? Next. So fifth adjustment is covered in that. Now sixth is for what I am doing this, and that is what in the next question you'll try on your own. Amount due to W is to be paid in cash. Means who is W? So in this question don't transfer it to loan. Clearly given. Amount due to be paid to W is to be paid in cash. So in this question, retiring partner's balance will not go to loan, it will straight away go to
cash.
Okay, further. And the same amount will be brought in cash by L and B, because we don't have that much money, 2000 is only there. What will we pay from 2000? His capital itself is 5000. So whatever amount we have to pay to W will be brought in cash by L and B in such a manner that the important point is this, and then their capital may remain in the new profit and loss sharing ratio in the new firm. This we have done yesterday also. Their capital should remain in new ratio. So what would you do? You would find the capital distributed in new ratio and write it as closing balance. Okay, but that step we'll do at the end. All this will begin after revaluations balancing. So first, liability side, creditors and outstanding expenses are untick. Write down creditors 20,000, outstanding expense 3,000. Okay. Asset side, debtors 13,000. Everything else is recorded. Any confusions up till here? Raise your hand, we're still writing the unticked items. All are written? 13,500 minus 500, 13,000. 2 partners capital account in bracket profit. 5,200, 5,200, 2,600 will distribute it in old ratio. 13,000 into 2 by 5, 5,200. 13,000 into 2 by 5, 5,200. 13,000 into 1 by 5, 2,600. Opposite side in partner's capital account by revaluation account, L's column 5,200, B's column 5,200, W's column 2,600. Is everyone clear up there? Any doubts in this?
No.
Raise your hand, we're still writing up there. Now in this question, the retiring partner W's balance is not to be transferred to loan. We are going to pay him in cash. Again, look at the last adjustment. Amount due to W is to be paid in cash. First, let us fulfill this. Amount due to W is to be paid in cash. So 5, 6, 16, 22, 24, 600. Credit both the sides. Minus 2100, 22,500. 22,500 to cash account in bracket balancing figure. So amount due to W is to be paid in cash. Understood that? Where will this come in? Cash account? Credit side, opposite side. Credit side by W's capital account 22,500. Don't worry. I already told you we don't have money. So how will we pay? We need to find it. LNB are going to bring. Is everyone clear with this? Now, how to find what amount they have to bring in the list of the conditions? First of all, see the remaining. Same amount will be brought in cash by LNB. In short, LNB have to bring 22,500. W is to be paid in cash, which we have paid 22,500. Same amount is to be brought by L and B. Means L and B have to bring 22,500. Important thing is in such a manner that their capital may remain in their new profit and loss ratio in the new firm. First of all, let us find what is their capital present. Means, you remember how we used to do that adjusted capital in the last chapter? So, first we'll find that adjusted capital, which here we will call it as new capital. The new capital after retirement of W. So, working note 5 is it?
Yes.
For L and D, this you have to do in the next question on your own class procedure. First we find partner's capital account credit minus debit. For L27,200, for W19,700, minus 13,200 and 9,200. We get new capital, which in the last chapter we used to call it as adjusted capital. One and the same. Is everyone clear with this? 14,000 and 10,500. See here, credit side total of L comes to 27,200. B's capital credit side total comes to 19,700. Minus debit side 13,200 and 9,200. So new capital is 14,000 and 10,500. Any confusion up till here? Now, can I say that total capital is 24,500 as of now? Can I say the capital of new firm is 24,500 as of now? Now we know that L and B are going to bring 22,500 to pay to W. L and B are going to bring 22,500 to pay to W. So will their capital increase by this 22,500 or not? If they bring 22,500 in the business, their capital will increase by 22,500. So plus cash to be brought by L and D, 22,500 in bracket, which is to be paid to W, that they have to bring. Raise your hand who did not understand this, why their capital will increase. L and B have to bring the amount what we are paying to W. So if they bring the amount, what will be the entry? Cash to capital. To capital means partner's capital, not credit side. Their capital will increase. They have to bring this 22,500 in the business, means their capital will increase. So after this, what will be the new capital?
47,000.
Is everyone clear with this? Now, this they have to keep in new ratio. Read the last adjustment. They have to bring cash in such a manner that their capital may remain in their new profit and loss sharing ratio in the new firm. Did you understand this? This should remain between L and B in the new ratio 21:90. We did that calculations. See in your notebook previous workings. 21:90 new ratio. 21/40, 19/40. 47,000 into 21/40, 24,675. 47,000 into 19/40, 22,325. Is everyone clear with this? This should be their capital in the firm now. Now this we have done yesterday. After they distribute the capital in new ratio, what should we do? Write it as closing balance. And then after writing it as closing balance, what will you do? Balancing amount, you'll transfer it to cash account. So these amounts will write it as closing balance to balance carried down in bracket working note 5 in else column 24675 in B's column 22325. Now definitely they have to bring the amount, so debit will only be more. So whatever amount remains on credit side, you'll transfer it to cash account. So 31,875 by cash account in bracket balancing field. Did you all understand how is this 10675 and 11825 obtained? Debit side total 37825 and 31525 minus credit side amounts. So they are bringing 10675 and 11825. Doing calculator, 10675 plus 11825. Are they bringing 22,500 or not?
Yes.
That is what was the decision. That whatever you have to pay to W, they have to bring. They are bringing 22,500. But what amounts they are bringing? 10675 L is bringing. 11825 W, sorry, B is bringing. They are bringing in such a manner that their closing capital becomes a new
ratio.
Did everyone understand this portion? Where will we write this in cash account?
Debit
side. Opposite side 2. Else capital account 10675 to B's capital account 11825. Understood that everyone? Now where will you write these two closing balances? Liabilities side. Capitals L 24675 B 22325 47,000, which we already know. The new capital is 47,000. Cash balance will come on asset side, it will be 2000 itself. 24,500 minus 22,500 2000 by balance carried down.
70,000.
Asset side cash 2000. And 70,000 is the total of balance sheet. This kind of questions are the most important questions in this chapter. Okay, not difficult at all. Is everyone clear with this? Next question I'll do on the board without any participation. Directly I'll explain it. But last part first you try on your own. Okay. First I'll discuss what is the difference in the last part. Then I'll discuss it. It's easier than this. The complicated one I've done on the board. Who all are still doing this? Raise your hand. All have completed? Look at question 11. Question 11. I'll just explain the different part first. Look at the last adjustment. After retirement of son, Moon and Star will maintain their capital. See, same language. Moon and Star will maintain their capital in new profit and loss ratio, and difference is to be transferred to
bank.
Instead of cash,
bank.
We'll be making bank accounting. Now tell me, is it given that amount to Star is to be paid in cash?
No.
Like it was given in the previous question. Is it mentioned amount to Star is to be paid in cash?
No.
Here Star's amount will transfer to his loan account. Here star's amount will transfer to his loan account. You not pay him in cash.
Son.
Son's amount you'll transfer it to loan account. You not pay him in cash. Now, is any cash to be brought to pay to son? So this addition you will not do. Directly whatever is the new capital, you'll distribute it in
new issue.
And what will happen if one partner brings same amount, other partner will withdraw, then only their capital will remain same total as we did earlier also. So here you will not add any cash to be brought because you don't have to pay to retiring partner. Straight away whatever amount you get, you'll distribute it in new ratio, write it as closing balance and transfer the balance to cash flow. So easier than this. Is everyone clear with it? So that part when we do it, you'll be doing it on your own. Make the formats and including bank account. Instead of cash, you'll make bank. Yes, I'll start with it now. We enter very first. Moon, star and sun are the partners of a firm. Now, no old ratio is given means it's 1:1:1 equal ratio. Sun retires on 31/3/17 means which partner? Third partner. Moon and star will distribute future profits and losses in the ratio of 5:1, that is. What is it, 5:1? New ratio. Market is NR, new ratio. Balance sheet of that firm on 31/3/17 was as under. Put tick on capital accounts by balance brought down 1,60,000, 2 lakhs, and 1,80,000. Put tick on bank. Two balance brought down 1,75,000. Did everyone write this? Put tick on general reserve. By general reserve. Yes, Jeetay, what is the problem? Why are you talking in between? 90,000 will distribute in old ratio, which we discussed is equal ratio. So 90,000 divided by 3, 30,000 each. Nothing else from the balance sheet to be distributed. Conditions of retirement. First, goodwill is valued at 60,000. For that, first we'll find gain ratio. Moon, star and sun. Stop talking! Old ratio is 1:1:1. Sun retires. New ratio in the beginning is given as 5:1. Gain ratio is new ratio minus old ratio. So 5/6 - 1/3. And same way 1/6 - 1/3. LCM is 6. 5 - 2. And 1 - 2. 3/6 - 1/6. Understood this everyone? 6/6. 1 × 5, 5. 6/3, 2 × 1, 2. 6/6, 1 × 1, 1. 6/3, 2 × 1, 2. -1 means sacrifice. Now, normally we pass the entry remaining partner to retiring. But we discuss if any partner sacrifices, then even that partner you will credit. Means your moon will give the compensation to sun who is retiring as well as to star because he is sacrificed. So for goodwill, the entry will be now only moon's capital account debit, remaining partner's capital account we debit in gain ratio. Only moon is gaining, so only moon's capital account debit, and star and sun both we will credit. To star's capital account, to sun's capital account. Did you understand this? And how to calculate the amounts? Simply, goodwill's value into 3/6 1/6, 1/3. What is goodwill's value given? 60,000. So moon will be 60,000 into 3/6, 30,000. Star will be 60,000 into 1/6, 10,000. And sun will be 60,000 into 1/3, 20,000. See, does debit and credit match or not?
Yes.
Are you all clear with this? Raise your hand who did not understand this. Now, debit side will write credit accounts to Star's capital account to Sun's capital account in bracket goodwill, Moon's column 10,000 and 20,000. Okay, debit side will write the credit accounts. Credit side will write the debit account by Moon's capital account in bracket goodwill, Star's column 10,000, Sun's column 20,000. Is everyone clear with the effects? Any confusion up till here? Creditors are payable after 1 month, which are to be paid immediately at 12% discount per annum. Now, how much is creditors' amount on the liability side? We have to pay them after 1 month, but we are paying them immediately. Means we had to pay them on 30th April, but we are paying them on 31st March itself, 1 month early. And they have given us discount of 12% but per annum. So 1 month discount will be equal to 60,000 into 12% into 1/12, 600. Any confusion in this? 12% is per annum. We are paying them 1 month early. So what will be 1 month's discount? 60,000 into 12% into 1/12. So we have to pay them 59,400. And it is given they are to be paid immediately. Can you see that? Which are to be paid immediately. So creditors account debit 60,000 to bank account 59,400, and discount and profit of 600 will go to revaluation account. 600. Understood this entry? Creditors account debit 60,000 to bank account, we will pay them 59,400, and to revaluation account with the profit and discount of 600. How much are creditors? When do we have to pay them? But we have to pay them, they are payable after 1 month. But they are, which are to be paid? Means we are paying them 1 month early. Now they are giving us discount of 12% per annum. So what will be 1 month's discount? 60,000 into 12% into 1/12, that is 600. So if you pay them after 1 month, then we have to pay 60,000. If you pay them right now, then we have to pay them 59,400. Okay, so 600 is our profit. So creditors account debit 60,000. To bank account we are paying 59,400, and to revaluation account with a profit of 600. Anyone else who is not clear with this, raise your hand. Now creditors account debit, the account gets closed. Put tick on creditors, they will not be recorded in balance sheet. They get closed. To bank, so bank account credit side by creditors account 59,400. Okay? And to revaluation, so revaluation account credit side by creditors account with a profit of 600. Any conclusions in this? All of you okay with that? Mark it important. This is just a new one. Now next, computer written off from the books. What do you mean by written off from the books?
Minus.
Zero. Asset side, do you have any computer?
No.
Because it's written off. Means in our books, its value has become
zero.
Understood that? Now is valued at 12,000. So is it a profit or loss?
Profit.
Its value had become? Now it's valued at 12,000. And Moon will take over the computer at this value. So Moon's capital account, debit. Moon is the receiver, debit the receiver. Moon's capital account, debit. Two? no two computer, two evaluation. We cannot credit two computer. Computer is not there only in balance sheet. We cannot say computer goes out, there is no computer in the balance sheet. Entire 12,000 is our? So two evaluation account. Understood that? What is the journal entry? Moon's capital account debit to revaluation account. Full 12,000 is our profit. So partner's capital account debit side to revaluation account in bracket computer Moon's column 12,000. Is everyone clear with it? Revaluation account credit side by Moon's capital account in bracket computer 12,000. Is everyone clear with this? Now fourth adjustment, I read it once again. After retirement of Sun, Moon and Star will maintain their capital in new profit and loss ratio. So we'll find the new capital as partner's capital account credit minus debit, and that amount we will maintain in new ratio. And the difference is to be transferred to bank account. So whatever new capitals will write it as closing balance, and difference we will transfer to bank account. Basically, whatever one will bring, the other will withdraw. Is everyone clear with this? But after revaluation accounts balancing. So liability side, bills payable 10,000. Untaked items will record because everything is untaked. Asset side, building 2,40,000, machinery 1,30,000, furniture 80,000, stock 45,000, debtors 30,000, bank account we are making it. Okay. Now revaluation account 12,600. Entire 12,600 is our profit. Partners capital account in bracket profit, will distribute it equally. Old ratio is equal ratio. 4,200, 12,600 divided by 3, 4,200. Partners capital credit side by revaluation account, 4,200. Now you make that workings. First of all, you'll transfer retiring partners amount to?
No.
Then you'll make that workings. I'll give you 5 minutes, try that on your own, then I'll show it on the board. The balance sheet must tell you after that. What part is not to be done in the workings? Nothing to be added back, because they're not supposed to bring any additional amount to be paid to retiring partner. First, retiring partner's amount you transfer to his loan account. Round it off. Tomorrow also, similar point will be done in the class. And that time I'll ask you and do the workings and see if you're able to answer it or not. And you already know if you could not answer, what will happen. Similar workings will take place tomorrow also. Anyone know about the balance sheet tally?
Yeah.
Who could get the balance sheet tally? Yes, complete silence now. I'm doing it on the board. Be attentive, everyone. Yes, I'm doing it and I want silence now. First of all, Sun's balance we will transfer to his loan account. So 180, 234, 200, 2,34,200 itself is the balance. That will be transferred to his loan account. To Sun's, silence! To Sun's loan account, in bracket balancing figure. Liability side, Sun's loan. 2,34,200. Again, who is this? Now we'll make that workings for Moon and Star. Partners capital account credit. So 194,200.
Minus 42,000.
And 2,44,200. Minus debit side is 42,000. And nothing for Star. New capital
1,52,200.
2,44,200. 396,400. Okay, this we have to distribute between moon and star.
In
new ratio, which is given as 5:1. 5 by 6, 1 by 6.
3,30,000.
396,400 × 5 by 6. 330,333. 396,400 × 1 by 6. 68067. Is everyone clear with it? That we will write as closing balance. 2 balance carried down. 330,333 and 66067. And whatever balancing figure remains will be transferred to bank. More debit is more. Yes, silence. So 372,333. 372,333 minus 194,200. 178,133 by bank account in bracket balancing figure. And star credit is more.
244,200
minus 66067. 1,78,133. To bank account in bracket balancing figure. Now this will come in bank account on credit side by star's capital account. Who is laughing in between? No, by star's capital account 178,133. And as I told you in the beginning itself, that whatever one partner will withdraw, the other will pay. So debit side to moon's capital account 178,133. Closing balance, we will write on liabilities side. Capitals moon 330,333 and star 66067, and total we already know is 396,400.
1,15,600
is the closing balance. It will come on asset side bank. 1,15,600. Did all of you understand this?
Yes, sir.
Tomorrow I'll ask you when we solve this kind of question. This work is you all must be able to do. Homework illustration 21 and 22.